to Egypt, introduce myself. I'm your guide and my name is Nadia.
Nadia.
Not from Russia. Not so trick. It's a one-day tour. So I need to go through with you our program in full details. And have you been here before, besides you? When was that, dear? When?
About 19.
Jesus Christ. It's the second largest city with a population of about 6 million inhabitants. And the population of Egypt is 80 million, 8-0. This is in spite of all the contraceptives, family plannings, and advertisements. It doesn't seem to help much, does it? We still increase every year 1 million. That's a problem, okay? Alexandria, ladies and gentlemen, was founded in the 4th century BC, named after its founder, Alexander the Great. And he founded Alexandria, the capital of Egypt and center of civilization, till the 7th century AD. In the 7th century AD, the Arabs conquered Egypt, by the way. I'm glad I remember that. When we say the Arabs conquered Egypt, and when we say Arabic, and when we say we speak Arabic, but we are not Arabs. Got it? We are Egyptians, Jewish, Christians, Muslims, in Egypt, Egyptians. And that's why I say the Arabs conquered Egypt, who came at that time from Saudi Arabia. And the commander-in-chief, Amr ibn al-As, entered the country through a Roman fortress of Babylon and founded the capital of Egypt in Old Cairo. We'll be crossing this area, called El-Fustat. And El-Fustat is the Arabic word for tent. We know that the Arabs said tents. Yeah. Ah. It is in tents, you know, and used to. Bedouins that walk barefoot and so on. On the 6th of October in 1973, this was the last war between Egypt and Israel. So that's it. Look at it here on your right. And ladies and gentlemen, the minarets are for the Muazzin to climb up and call the prayers. And they pray 5 times a day, as I explained, and climbing the minarets. Now a day, very different outfits. By the way, look at this street now. Because you are coming back, I won't be with you tonight. The streets, they start going out at 11, at night. No, late at night. Like what? Of course, the more 11, but let us say
since... Are we in Ramadan now?
No, we're not in Ramadan.
It's Ramadan.
No, sir, why? What made you think it's Ramadan?
No, I didn't know.
Ramadan,
you know, it changes every year.
Yeah, I know. No, it not. And these people come here late in the afternoon and they stay till 4 a.m. in the morning. Thousands of people here shopping and things like that. Ladies and gentlemen, ahead of us is Muhammad Ali Square. And we are crossing the old part of the city. And if you look straight ahead, you will see the statue of Muhammad Ali on his horse, made of bronze. Can you see it?
Yes.
Sculptured by the French sculptor Jacques Mar. You notice very much different outfits in our country. Like what? Women. Lots of women wearing black, covered all in black. It does not mean that all these women are mourning, of course. This is an old custom, ladies and gentlemen. Because you know what? Women, they only wear black when they get married. They don't mourn because they got married, but they wear black because it's not very attractive and doesn't show the shape of their bodies. You will see also men wearing long robes. It's nothing religious. This is an old custom. Did you know that the Egyptian cotton is the best all over the world? No or yes?
Yes.
It's true, honestly. The best cotton, and they wear them made of the pure Egyptian cotton. It gives them cool in summer, and they feel more comfortable, and they call them galabiyah. In other Arab countries, maybe you've heard the word jalaba. That is different, the galabiyah. Okay, never worked till now, the French. It's not working, this clock. Anyhow, Le Bas, it took him 6 years to take the obelisk from Cairo to Paris. Hatshepsut is 6 months. Okay, so it was really, they were great. So ladies and gentlemen, the stones came, some of them from Aswan and some of them from the quarries, 8 miles far from here. That's nothing, that's a mole. You have lots of moles at home, don't you? Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, the second pyramid is the tomb of King Khafre. In respect for his father, built his pyramid 3 feet less in height. And it was built in 2650 BC. The grandson, Mykerinus, was built in 2600 BC. I'll be back. I told you that's the mall. KFC, McDonald's, Hardee's, here you are. Dandy, Nokia. I'm going to stop first near the second pyramid, okay? At 6th of October City. Ladies and gentlemen, to the right is the Mina House Hotel. And this hotel was built as a palace in 1869 by Kedef Ismail. When he inaugurated the Suez Canal, invited lots of kings and Tsar of Russia to assist the inauguration of the canal, and he built this hotel for the kings and the wife of Napoleon.
Thank you. 我出嚟上面啲地台咧。
係啊，哇！
都仲好
啊，實
正啊！
我都有啲
地台啦，
嗱嗰啲咁嘅窿，好多一路。
Excuse me， 點解唔開？
應該唔會噶啦。
But they don't tell the girls what will they find. Only men.
Hey, I can tell most of your names, all right? You're all from the US?
Yes.
Hong Kong.
Boston.
Boston. Boston, Massachusetts. That's in the US too. There's something there about that. You are also?
No.
Where? It was made from this plant, papyrus, like thousands of years ago. It's very simple. Papyrus was made holy for the Egyptians because of the blossoming part that is so much like the sun rays, the symbol of Ra, the god of the sun at the time. And the second reason was the stem that is amazingly triangular, just like a pyramid shape, symbol of eternal life. Have you seen the pyramid?
Yes.
They're still there? Have you gone inside? Anybody went inside?
No.
You missed my grandfather next time. To make one of those ones, all you need to do is decide the size, if it was big or small. And accordingly, we cut so many pieces. If we're making a small one like this here, you may need more than 30 pieces, 35, just to come up with a small papyrus like that. We start by peeling the greenish part. That peel was found to be so strong and very flexible. They use it for making ropes, baskets, sandals, papyrus boats and canoes, and many things to use in the house, but not the paper. The paper would be made from the inner part. The inside has to be cut into thin slices, as I'm doing here. And the problem is, it breaks so easily. To make it strong and useful, they pound it. Having no instruments, they use the stones. They pound it. Maybe that's why we call our money 1 pound. Using the rolling pin would just make it so much easier. Ladies recognize this, right? In the kitchen, for the husbands. You can also tell I'm married here. Now it becomes very flexible and strong. That's international, right? I can tell the married ones. You're not married or married just a little while ago? Yeah, all right. See how long we leave it in the water? 2 days for the white papyrus, 6-7 days for the brown ones. The longer you leave it, the darker it becomes. Then what happens? We get 2 pieces of carpet. In the ancient times, they used the skin of the animals or the linen fibers. Between these 2 sheets, we weave the slices just like that. Horizontal one, again, is the vertical one. And you keep doing this weaving until eventually it will all become a complete square papyrus paper just like the ones behind us. Can you see the pattern here? You can actually see it easily on the papyrus itself over there. as we do a whole one, we just put the second piece on top to absorb the water, keep it flat, and finally take it all underneath the press. Again, in the ancient days, they had nothing like this. They used big rocks, stones. Thank God they made this for me. And we leave it there about 6 to 7 days. You have time for this? Like the cooking lessons, I think we have an example here. The one made earlier, strong. See how strong? Very flexible. And again, it's the light you can see through. That's how you tell this is good papaya. Transparent. As plain as they are. Of course, that's a small example. With different sizes, we send them to the School of Art, and they start painting those famous ones, inspired by the ones at the Egyptian Museum, Luxor, Aswan, the Valley of Kings and Queens all over the country. Each and every one of them has a magnificent story behind. We have thousands of them, but I would just choose a couple, well, like two, three pieces to give you an example. That would be from the masterpieces, the important ones. Number one would be the Judgment Day. The final judgment is the one piece that shows the Egyptians' mythology of the resurrection, the journey in which they took from this life to eternal life in paradise. It begins here. You see the divine judges, 14, asking him all sorts of questions about his life. When they give him the key of life, that means they think he's an innocent man. Half dead and half did not. So it's a tie there. That's why they had to send him down to Anubis the jackal. Have you been to the museum yet?
No.
You'll see that. Anubis would weigh his heart against the feather of man, the goddess of truth, on the scale of justice. If your heart is light, you're innocent. If your heart is heavy, you're guilty. They believe your heart keeps the good deeds and the bad deeds, love and hatred. That's their way. If the heart is light, as in here, the statement says he's innocent, no punishment. That was written by Fat, the god of knowledge and wisdom. He would pass him over to Horus, the falcon, the god of sky and horizon. Horus would escort him to heaven, where he meets Osiris, the god of paradise, Isis, the goddess of love, and Nephthys, the goddess of magic and power. Where was the story taken from? Here, in hieroglyphics. It would take 3-4 weeks in details, honestly. But I just gave you the conclusion to save your time. What happens when you buy one? You get the story in English with it. You translate the whole thing. The second famous one is the calendar. It's the first calendar they ever had. It shows north, south, east, and west, the 4 directions. Summer, spring, winter, and fall, the season. By either Horus, the falcon, the god of protection, or his mother Isis, the goddess of love and beauty. 12 images are the months of the year. There are 2 hands accordingly at 24, like the hours of one day, and inside everybody's star sign. Leo, Scorpio, Libra, Pisces, Aries, Taurus, 1123 BC. That was in Dendra, it's now in the Louvre in Paris. Every piece that you see around has a good story. I just gave you an example. You will see a lot of these shapes. Of course, you know what a cartouche is by now, do you? Kings and queens used to have their names in there, luck, spirit, and eternal life, and what it represents. And you can write, this is Maria, for example. It takes a minute to write your names inside, friends, family members, it's a good gift. And it costs like 10 Egyptian pounds, which is roughly like 2 US dollars or 2 Canadian dollars, or 1 English pound, or 1 Cyprus pound. Every painting has 2 numbers, as you can see there. NO, that's the model number, the number of the piece. LE stands for the price in Egyptian pounds. 70 would be roughly 12, 13 American or Canadian dollars. It would be like 7 English pounds. You don't have to pay cash here. You can pay in credit card. You can pay in cash, US dollars or Egyptian pounds. There's no tax. This is tax-free. And what happens when you get one? You don't carry the glass. It comes rolled up in a nice tube like this to travel light and protect it. And then they give you the instruction of how to make your own frame so easily as well. Every one of you have that greenish card, number one, the green card. That's did you get that from the immigration here? If you flip it over and you look on the back, you will find that there's a model number, quantity, and a price. That's where you place your order and you put the number here, the price. By the way, they come in different sizes and colors. Me and my colleagues around will help you the best that we can do about the stories. Don't hesitate to ask about the story. This is our job. Finally, thank you very much for your good listening. You've been so kind. Enjoy your shopping around.
Don't run over the people.
Mm-hmm.